leaving me now. Conviction in a heart, crying out to the heavens on the plains of Arafat. Standing proud beside my brother, silent at Muzdalifah.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Nahmaduhu wa nusalli ala rasulihil kareem. Amma ba'd. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I welcome all the viewers of Peace TV for this unique series of interviews wherein we are discussing on a very interesting and a very important topic of the virtues of the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. And to enlighten us on this topic, we have in our studios today our dear Sheikh, Sheikh Haitham Al Had from UK. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Sheikh, alhamdulillah, we have discussed in detail in the previous episodes about the importance of dhikr to be done during this first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. Are there any other acts of worship that which are more virtuous as compared to the other acts of worship during these 10 days? We would like to know, inshallah, in this episode about that.
Yes, bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salam ala rasulillah. Any act of ibadah, any act of the listed ibadat, salah, siyam, even sadaqah, and obviously we will be doing hajj. But many scholars used to do what the umrah during these 10 days. Many of the salaf used to do their umrah in these 10 days. In fact, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam, he performed his umrah in this month. He did hajj qiran, so he intended hajj and umrah
during his hajj.
And many scholars used to do separate umrah in these 10 days. So any act regarding salah, increasing your salah, in particular observing the 12 rak'ah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, you know, in Hadith Umm Habiba, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever prays 12 rak'ah every day, Allah will build for him a house in Jannah. 2 before Fajr, 4 before Dhuhr, 2 after Dhuhr, 2 after Maghrib, 2 after Isha. Observe as much as we can of Qiyamul Layl. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَعَلَمْ أَنَّ شَرَفَ الْمُؤْمِنِ قِيَامُهُ بِاللَّيْلِ. The honor of the believer is what?
The night prayer.
The night prayer. Allah jalla wa ala says, كَانُوا قَلِيلًا مِنَ اللَّيْلِ مَا يَهْجَعُونَ وَبِالْأَسْحَارِ هُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ. They used to sleep little. Now we make qiyam little. This is provided that we make qiyam. وَبِالْأَسْحَارِ هُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ. During the last third of the night, they are making what? Istighfar. It is the time that Allah Jalla wa Ala descends to the lowest heaven. And the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, Afdalu Salah, the best Salah. After Al Mafruḍa is what?
The night
the Salah,
prayer.
Yes, at night, the night prayer. Whether after Isha,
Or the first part of the night, or the last part of the night.
And in fact, as we mentioned, Sa'id ibn Jubayr, he used to make Qiyamul Layl the whole night.
Allah.
And he used to say, don't put off your lights in these nights. So this is Salah. And in particular, the Furud, the Fara'id, we need to improve their quality.
Of course, we cannot improvise on the quantity. It's a quality that we can
quality.
Improve.
The one of the Salaf, he used to say that when I go to study hadith with a scholar or to narrate from him some of the hadith that he used to narrate, I used to look first how he prays. If he used to pray perfectly, well, means with khushu', humbleness, good quality salah, then I will take from him. But if he not to pray very well.
Hasty salah.
Yeah, hasty salah, not khushu' salah. I said, if he is not mindful of his salah, not guarding his salah, then obviously he will lose any other thing else.
Allah. As though it was an indicator for the muhaddithin.
Yeah, it is the standard.
SubhanAllah.
It is the standard. So if he preserves this, then obviously he will preserve anything else. If he just lose this and ignore this, neglect this, he will be more negligent of any other thing. We need also to look at other optional prayers. Salatul Duha. The Prophet ﷺ said to Abu Huraira, don't miss three things. And Abu Huraira said, my beloved Prophet advised me not to miss three things. One of them is what?
The Duha prayer.
Yes, Duha prayer. The Prophet ﷺ said, Salatul Awabin, Hina Tarmudul Fisal. Salatul Awabin means in the Duha when it is a little bit hot, means when the sun rises a little bit. Also, sitting, doing dhikr of Allah Jalla wa Ala after praying Fajr in Jama'ah. And praying Salah in Jama'ah. See, I'm living in London, and in a Muslim country, Alhamdulillah, around me there are 10 masajid. I always say to the brothers, don't live far away from the masjid. That's because the masjid, wallahi, changes your life. Masjid, the presence of masjid, builds iman in your heart. The best places on earth, as the Prophet ﷺ said, masajiduha. Yeah? And sometimes we tend to live away from masjid. Why? Because maybe the area around the masjid is a poor area. Like in many European countries, because it is a Muslim area, and unfortunately Muslims, they don't look after their areas properly, or the governments neglect those areas. Normally you find masajid there. No, live around the masjid in order to be able to pray jama'ah. Jama'ah, as the Prophet ﷺ said, and all of us know this hadith. No one doesn't know that Salatul Jama'ah is
27 times
of the Salah individually. No one doesn't know this hadith. Sulaiman ibn Hamza, one of the greatest scholars, he was a qadi. He said when he was 90 years of age, he said, I have never prayed by myself. Means by myself, not jama'ah. For all of my life except 2 times.
SubhanAllah.
And when I missed the jama'ah, in these 2 times only, he's counting them. See? He was 90 years of age. And he's been praying minimum for 8 years.
SubhanAllah.
Yeah, for 80 years, or let us say 75 years, when he became mature. He never missed jama'ah except 2 times.
SubhanAllah.
Sa'id ibn al-Musayyib said to his daughter when he was on his deathbed, obviously she was sad, worried. He said, my daughter, don't worry about me. You know, because next to death, you need to put more hope in Allah Jalla wa'ala. He said, don't be worried about me. By Allah, I did not pray in the second line in the masjid for 50 years.
SubhanAllah. The first row.
The first row. In one narration, he said, except when I had something, an affair with Abdul Malik or Sulaiman ibn Abdul Malik, the leader, the Khalifa.
Yes.
So this is Salah. We can talk a lot about it.
Definitely.
I know we
Definitely,
have short
Sheikh.
Time. After Salah, I would like to mention Siyam.
Yeah.
Fasting. By the way, in most of this literature that we find that people talk about Siyam, they don't talk about Salah. And the importance of Salah and
because
increasing
we know that
your Salah
is more important.
in these 10 days.
Definitely.
Yeah, we need to talk first about Salah. Salat al-Jama'ah, Nawafil Salah, night prayer, Duha prayer, etc.
Definitely.
After that is Siyam.
Siyam.
Now, when we talk about Siyam, again, some people who study, they discuss whether Siyam is the best thing, or why didn't the Prophet ﷺ fast? The hadith that reported that the Prophet ﷺ used to fast the first 9 days of Dhul Hijjah week. No, some other scholars believe that it is strong. Who reported this hadith? A person called Hunayd ibn Khalid. He reported it from his wife, and his wife reported it from one of the wives of the Prophet ﷺ, that he used to fast the first 9 days of Dhul Hijjah, and this discussion. Most of the scholars believe that it is highly recommended sunnah to fast all the 9 days. And it was reported by many of the Salaf that they used to fast what? the 9 days of Dhul Hijjah.
MashaAllah.
All of them.
Not just specific the 9 day of Arafah. All the nine days.
It is an opportunity.
Definitely.
It is an opportunity. Why do we lose it? And we all know that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that Allah spoke about the virtues of fast.
Definitely. In a hadith, a famous hadith Qudsi.
Famous hadith Qudsi. Everyone knows about it. When Allah jalla wa ala says, "Kullu amal ibn Adam lahu illa as-sawm fa innahu li." Each action of the son of Adam belongs to him except for fasting. Fasting belongs to me.
And I will reward him for
that. And I will reward for it. In one narration, Al-Hasan, the famous narration of Bukhari, Al-Hasana is by 10. And in Sahih Muslim, Al-Hasana is multiplied by 10 up to 700 times, up to even more than that. And one of the scholars, Al-Hasan al-Basri, he said fasting one day in those 10 days is equal to fasting 2 months.
Allahu Akbar.
Each day is equal to what?
Fasting 2 months.
2 months. If we go for the first narration, Al-Amal, working hard in one day is equal like working hard for 1,000 days.
Yes.
Then fasting one day is equal to fasting what? 1,000 days. Subhanallah, you fast one day, this is equal to what? Fasting almost 3 years.
3 years of fasting. The fasting of one day, mashallah. Inshallah, we will continue on this, but after a short break.
Crying out to the heavens on the plains of Arafat. لبيك اللهم لبيك
لبيك اللهم لبيك
لبيك لا شريك لك
لبيك لا شريك لك.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is Yasir Fazaga. To all of our brothers and sisters going for Hajj, may you have a safe journey and may all your deeds be accepted.
If I were to ask you about the life of our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, about the incidents that occurred before his prophethood and in Mecca and in Medina, about the names of his loved ones and his wives and his children, how much would we be able to know? How many incidents have we memorized? Brothers and sisters, isn't it more important that we study the seerah of the most important human being who ever walked the face of this earth? Join me, your host Yasir Qadhi, as we discuss the most important biography of the most illustrious human being that ever lived, the seerah of our beloved Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
Join Yasir Qadhi in Seerah of the Prophet, peace be upon him, every Monday at 3:30 p.m. and repeat telecast at 2 a.m. Saudi Arabia on Peace TV. Let's come under the shade of the scholars.
So the issue is a problem of knowledge.
Asim Al-Hakim.
Why do people do bid'ah?
Imam Malik said, whoever claims there is a good innovation in the deen.
Salim Al-Amri.
He is accusing that Prophet Muhammad did not convey the message.
Dr. Mamduh Muhammad.
If you know that the Prophet ﷺ did something and I do something else, you have to follow the Prophet ﷺ, don't follow me.
Abdul Rahim McCarthy.
But if each one believes his goal is to please Allah, to follow the Sunnah of Rasulullah
ﷺ. Abdul Rahim Green.
I think this really is to do with your internal state.
Where does the Quran and Sunnah point to?
Muhammad Al-Sharif.
We have to follow what Allah and His Messenger said.
Let's imbibe from these scholars the fruitful solutions for the problems of the world.
Which one we would take and which one we would leave?
Question to every Muslim.
Question to every Muslim.
In the shade of the scholars. Next on Peace TV.
Crying out to the heavens on the plains of Arafat.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We were continuing to talk about the virtue of fasting in the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. Yes, Sheikh.
So fasting is one of the virtuous activities and actions that we need to do. In these 9 days, obviously it is haram to fast the last day because it is a day of Eid.
Definitely.
And more important is to fast Arafah, and we will talk about Arafah, inshallah.
Inshallah, in a separate episode, inshallah.
Inshallah. But before that, just fast every day.
Okay, mashallah.
Every day. And subhanallah, those women who are experiencing their menses or they are in postnatal, period. If they used to fast previously, in those 10 days, it will be counted for them as if they were fasting.
MashaAllah. So it's a good news for the sisters as well.
Because Allah Jalla wa'ala is just.
Definitely.
But Allah Jalla wa'ala wants to see us.
It is the intention which is
working hard.
Definitely.
Otherwise, Allah Jalla wa'ala is generous. Allah Jalla wa'ala gives.
Definitely.
Allah Jalla wa'ala gives nothing, yani nothing.
Nothing is less for Allah Subhanahu
yes.
wa ta'ala. His bounties are always open for us.
And
all.
He is so keen. He's so keen that we go to Jannah and we get the best place in Jannah. But it is up to us. So this is fasting.
Definitely.
Again, sadaqah in general. Sadaqah is one of the most virtuous acts. Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, one time the good deeds were yani, showing off what is the best of the good deeds. He said, sadaqah won in the Quran. يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تلهكم أموالكم ولا أولادكم عن ذكر الله ومن يفعل ذلك فأولئك هم الخاسرون. Don't be deceived by your wealth and your children, and don't let them take you away
from the remembrance of Allah.
See, the remembrance. Again, back to the remembrance.
The zikr.
Dhikr. Dhikr is the essence of our life. And ومن يفعل ذلك فأولئك هم الخاسرون. Those who do this, they will be what?
They will be the losers.
The losers. And then Allah Jalla wa'ala says, وَأَنْفِقُوا مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاكُمْ مِنْ قَبْلِ أَنْ يَأْتِيَ أَحَدَكُمُ الْمَوْتِ فَيَقُولَ رَبِّ لَوْلَا أَخَّرْتَنِي إِلَىٰ أَجَلٍ قَرِيبٍ
فَأَصَّدَّقَ وَأَقُمْ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ.
When the day of death comes, yeah, Allah Jalla wa'ala says, spend before the day of death comes. When the day or the time of death comes, what will be the first thing you remember? And what will be the first thing you will ask Allah to do?
Spend in the cause of Allah.
To give sadaqah.
Allahu Akbar.
فَيَقُولَ رَبِّ لَوْ لَا أَخَّرْتَنِي إِلَىٰ جَلٍ قَرِيبٍ. Just a few seconds in order to what? To
give sadaqah. وَأَكُمْ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ.
To give sadaqah. In the hadith of Sahih al-Bukhari, the Prophet ﷺ said, spend. Because the best time for you to spend, أن تصدق وأنت صحيح تخشى الفقر وتأمل الغنى. You are afraid of being poor, of poverty, and you wish to be rich, and you are healthy. وليس, and it is not the best sadaqah that when you are about to die, خلاص, yeah, sick, you have no hope in this life, you will not enjoy your money anymore, and then you say, oh, لفلان كذا ولفلان كذا ولفلان كذا. Give this, give this, give this, give this. No. The best sadaqah is to give sadaqah before. And we know, من ذا الذي يقرض الله قرضا حسنا فيضاعفه له أضعافا كثيرة. Who is يقرض? يقرض means what?
Loan.
Loan. يعني, when I give £1, I am giving it not to the faqir, not to the poor person. I'm giving it to who?
Allah.
To Allah. And I'm giving it to Allah as what? Allah doesn't need money.
He's free from such things.
Yes. Allah Jalla wa'ala says, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِنَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ مَا أُرِيدُ مِنْهُمْ مِنْ رِزْقٍ. I don't need any provision. وَمَا أُرِيدَ أَنْ يُطْعِمُونَ. إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الرَّزَّقُ. Allah is the one who gives everything. And this al-mal, وَأَنْفِقُوا مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاكُمْ. Allah says, spend from what we gave you.
It's just an amana for us.
Yes, it is amana that we are just entrusted in this money. Anyway, so sadaqah, my dear brothers. Sadaqah. Prophet ﷺ said to women, tasaddaqu, tasaddaqu. I saw you, most of the people, in the fire of hell. It seems, by the way, that sadaqah is the last chance or the last resort that saves you from the fire of hell.
Allahu.
That's why, my dear brothers and sisters, always when you see a chance to give a sadaqah, just give it. Even if it is one penny, if it is something worthless.
Worthless. Save yourself from the fire of hell, even if it be with a date.
Yes, with a piece of date, not bishatri. One of the early scholars, he used to give sadaqah every day. And one time, he kept an onion in his pocket. So one of his colleagues told him, his name is Zayd al-Khair. He told him, an onion in your pocket, it will spoil the smell. He said, Wallahi, I am giving sadaqah every day, and I will not stop giving that after I heard my sheikh, who is the companion of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Uqba ibn Amir. He narrated that he heard the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Al-mar'u fi dhilli sadaqatihi yawm al-qiyamah. The person will be under the shade of his sadaqah on the day of resurrection. So he said, I was looking in my house for something to give as a sadaqah. I did not find anything. I found one onion. I said, maybe I'll take it, I'll give it to one poor person, he will make use of it.
MashaAllah, Shaykh. Alhamdulillah.
So sadaqah. Yeah? So we mentioned salah.
We mentioned siyam.
And we also mentioned sadaqah. And previously we mentioned dhikr.
The dhikr of Allah.
In general, any act of ibadah, listed ibadat, it should be done on these days.
Yes, alhamdulillah. Jazakallah khair, Shaykh. So we even spoke about Umrah and the Hajj to be done during these days. And besides this, there is another act of worship, Shaykh, that which we refer to as the Udhiyah.
The Udhiyah,
that which is to be done. So can you please enlighten our audiences that how important is this act of worship called Udhiyah during these first 10 days?
Okay. First of all, the Udhiyah is, what is the definition of the Udhiyah? Listen, my dear brothers and sisters, I'll try to summarize the rulings of the Udhiyah. The Udhiyah is a sheep or a ram or a goat.
Goat. From the same family.
Yeah, from the same family. Or a cow.
Cow.
Or a camel. These three.
Inshallah.
To be slaughtered for Allah, for the sake of Allah Jalla wa Ala. After Salatul Eid. Salatul Eid takes place on the 10th of Dhul Hijjah. After Salatul Eid. And you can eat from it. You can give sadaqah from it. You can give gifts from it. If you want to keep it all, you can keep it all. If you want to give it sadaqah all, give it sadaqah all. If you want to give it as a gift all, you can keep it as a gift all. So this is the Udhiyah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said in Hadith Aisha, authentic hadith, most of the scholars believe that it is authentic, that ما عمل المؤمن عملا قط يوم النحر, that the person will not do on يوم النحر an act more pleasing to Allah جل وعلا than sacrificing an udhiyah.
Allah, the best act to be done.
The best act. That's why the scholar said the best time for the udhiyah is to do it on the 10th. So it will be in the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah.
Although it is permissible for the consecutive 3 days.
As you know, as our audience know, that the time to slaughter the udhiyah is the 10th or 11th or 12th up to 13, according to the Jumhur. Up to 13, up to the Asr of 13.
Inshallah.
Up to the Asr of 13, which is the last day of Tashriq.
Tashriq. The Ayam al-Tashriq.
Ayam al-Tashriq. Okay? This is the Udhiyah. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in that hadith, وَإِنَّهَا تَقَعُ عَلَى اللَّهِ. Yeah? يعني the thawab of it is granted by Allah when the person slaughters it before it and the wall of it falls on the ground.
Allah. The reward already reaches Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Khalas. Yeah? This is the udhiyah. Now, many people say, what to do with the udhiyah? We said, if you want to eat it all, alhamdulillah. When if you want to eat it, to give it as a sadaqah, alhamdulillah, anything. Because the key thing is sacrificing it for the sake of Allah Jalla wa Ala. Allah Jalla wa Ala says in the Quran, Inna a'tainaka al-kawthar, fasalli li rabbika wanhar. An-nahr, nahr sacrificing, the udhiyah is one of the acts that Allah Jalla wa Ala likes the most. And in Surah Al-Hajj, in the verses that talk about Hajj, when Allah Jalla wa Ala was talking about Hadi, Allah Jalla wa Ala says in Surah Al-Hajj, لَنْ يَنَالَ اللَّهَ لُحُومُهَا وَلَا دِمَاؤُهَا وَلَكِنْ يَنَالُهُ التَّقْوَى.
Definitely.
So when the person is sacrificing, obviously Allah Jalla wa'ala will not benefit from the
meat and the blood.
Meat and the flesh and blood. No. What reaches Allah Jalla wa'ala is what?
Your taqwa.
Your taqwa. And as we said, it should be slaughtered by the person. This is the highest status. Why? Because it means the person himself feels that he is sacrificing something for the sake of Allah Jalla wa'ala. He feels the act of ibadah. Now, obviously, in many countries, this might not be a forgotten thing now. Yeah, no, in Britain, it's very difficult for us to slaughter by ourselves. Definitely. So if that is the case, you can appoint someone to slaughter on your behalf.
Jazakallahu khairan, Sheikh. Alhamdulillah, we learnt about the various other acts of worship that which can be done during these first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. Inshallah, we will continue to speak more on the topic of Udhiyah in our coming episode. Until then, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
All across ocean and land, incumbent on all men, is the pilgrimage to Mecca, fifth